Hey everybody, I'm going to show you a different way to do a mallet technique where you tilt it and alter it after, get these out of the way, after you hit it with the mallet, and it gives a look that I really like because it gives those dark color kind of the cell outlines. So starts the same way. I mean, all of it's pretty much. So I'm just gonna pour my paint, the Dutch Boy DuraClean, which has been mixed with Floetrol and water. And my canvas feels so light. I've been working on the thick gallery ones, that this feels like nothing. Feels like just nothing's there. I had bought canvases last week and I thought, oh yay, canvases, and now I'm going through them too fast. It's never enough. Never enough. Just like candy. Okay. So, alright, all my sides are covered. So I'm going to start a little silicone into this one. Just to get some silicone onto the canvas. There we go. And some orange. So these paints, they're various brands. Some are Grumbacher, some are Liquitex. These paints were mixed with Floetrol water, and Liquitex pouring medium. Alrighty, so this is gonna be mess because that's big. So I'm just gonna smack it in the middle. Woo! That was messy. Really messy. All right, so you can see this now. I'm just going to tilt it, and if you'll see how when I'm starting to tilt, you're getting these. That's what I like. So I'm just gonna This gives you just a bunch of unique formations because hitting it disperses the paint in such a unique way, and then tilting it, you know, then I'm stretching it out all over the canvas. guys can see this. I'd move you closer now that I'm done hitting it, but now my hands are so dirty. Looks like fairy wings. And now that I'm tilting it back that way, see how all of these colors now have lightened like that? I kind of want this part off because it's too bright. Like it's just not going with the rest of it anymore. But it's coming. Here, I guess I will. I'll move you closer because I bet you guys can't see anything.
Oh, you actually can.
See me better or worse from where you were, but I feel like you're closer to me now. So I love this. I love the marbling effect. I'm still gonna get this little part off. Just because it doesn't go. There we go. That's enough. And now, because that's where I did my finger, because it wasn't moving right. So I'm going to tilt it a little bit this way so that it blends, because I don't really want my thumb prints. There's not as much paint on the canvas anymore, so you see how this is being stretched out? I actually like that. This part really doesn't want to move over here, though. It might just be how it's gonna be. I think I poured white. Yeah. At least get rid of those little finger parts. Those are weird. So I just think this gives a cool look. See, they're back, but at least now they're back on their own instead of a result of my finger. Now they're more organic. I love this look. I love the marbleization. This is my favorite, the webbing. I guess webbing, kind of spider webs. So I'm just going to tilt it a little bit back this way, because that but not too much, because I am, you know what? No, I'm leaving it, because I'm pretty happy with it. So I just think this gives a unique look to a pour that you really can't, that I've never accomplished in any way besides this. So yeah. So where's look how good I was. I torched from so far away, and it was just to pop some air bubbles. I did not over-torch. Yes! For the first time. Okay. Alright, so I will... Let's see. Now I need to quit messing with it, though. Make sure the sides are all good. All right, I love it. And it's getting darker. You can see. There's that part that I was talking about that I think is so cool. Just move you over to this side. This is a neat area right here. So if you like this video, click like. And I'd love it if you'd subscribe. And thanks for watching. Let me zoom it out again. And there you have it. Hammer and tilt. Thanks for watching.